Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the minority whip of the Senate is representing the Senate President. It is my pleasure to be with you today to declare open the public hearing on this important bill that will provide proper legislation to checkmate the ugly incidents of sexual harassment in our tertiary institution. The 8th Senate, as part of our legislative agenda, resolved to take necessary legislative initiative to promote equality and inclusiveness and ensure that the rights for women, youth, and vulnerable people in the society are adequately addressed. Distinguished senators and invited guests, complaints of sexual harassment in our places of learning is on the rise, and this dangerous trend has quite a significant impact on the quality of learning life and dignity of our children as a whole. Sexual harassment incidences are beginning to factor dangerously into our higher institution in such a manner that we can no longer ignore, otherwise we will be abdicating our responsibilities to make laws for the peace, order, and good government of the Federation. This menace has the potential of hindering academic excellence among our students, most especially the female students. One of the greatest achievements African women have made in their quest for empowerment has been in the area of education. And this bill, when passed into law, will further make the academic environment more accommodating for all who seek excellence. Yes, we have laws dealing with sexual offenses in general, just like we have for many other offenses. But in this regard, we are paying significant attention and treating this matter as a special challenge that requires specific and more detailed direct attention. This is in recognition of the many dimensions of its impact. We are also doing this to further send a message to all those who have utilized the seeming gaps in our body of law to perpetrate this evil and destroy the hope of our children. This bill must also be seen as a message to our children that we hear their cries and we cannot sit idly by and watch. Let this also sound as a marching order to our law enforcement agencies to develop and adapt greater attention to deal with the growing menace and nip it in the bud. Making laws is not enough. The executive arm must begin to pay attention to the right issues affecting our lives as a people, including those with direct impact on our people. Enjoyment of liberty, freedom, and aspiration, we cannot continue to focus on less impact areas of our lives while people suffer on the streets, and the quality of individual lives continue to dwindle due to lack of government attention. It is time for our children to feel safe again in schools and worry more about learning than of their safety and protection. This is what government is about. At this juncture, I must commend the initiator of this bill, Senator Obi Amo-Omo Agege, for the timelines and thoroughness, and also the Senate Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters for their commitment in ensuring we are all here to help contribute to making this bill a good piece of legislation. I am very confident that the intellectual contributions from academic personalities, civil society organizations, and students here present will enrich this bill so that when eventually passed into law, our students can have the best possible protection of the law to ensure that sexual depravity is no longer a factor of consideration as they seek to shape their future and enhance our national productivity through learning. With these few remarks of mine, it is my pleasure to now declare this public hearing open. Thanks for your attention.